Good morning, everyone. Michael Gurley here, September 8th, 2017, with my podcast. I speak from my written blog at michaelgurley.org, and I've called this episode Yesterday, Today, Tomorrow. I stayed up a little late last night working on a project that must be completed in some near-final form by Monday. Today is Friday. Yesterday was Thursday. Of course, that makes tomorrow Saturday. Guests arrived today and the house is ready. We have a loaded schedule for the weekend and the schedule is tight for a lot of things to get accomplished. I cannot dwell on tomorrow because the work of yesterday is spilling over into today. In fact, in times like these, all my days seem to be a blur. Nothing wraps up as completed on a single day, but appears to spread out over a three-day period of yesterday, today, and tomorrow. That never-ending cycle of past, present, and future. You know, the instructions on the shampoo bottle, wash, rinse, repeat. They never tell you when to get off that train. Sort of like that song we sang in the car as kids. A rabbit ain't got no tell-it-all, tell-it-all, tell-it-all. A rabbit ain't got no tell-it-all, just a powdered puff. Same song, second verse. Could get better, but it's going to get worse. Then repeat that song to ad nauseum until you're tired of the jingle, the words, and the giggles. At least 99 bottles of beer on the wall had an ending. I share all of this to answer a question put to me in a webinar this week. Why are you here? What's your purpose? Is what you're doing fulfilling your reason for existence? You know these kinds of questions. Life-changing or life-affirming. The answers contain wisdom in attempting to identify the rat race we have joined, and can we make sense of the reason we started running? Is there a destination, or are we simply running because everyone else is? Does this race have a purpose, or can I bail off the tracks of the masses and strike out through my own life as my purpose unfolds? What drives me? What makes me content with the work I'm focused on? If money, time, or burdens were not the weight keeping me running as I've always run, then what would I want to do that makes sense for me? Now, before anyone calls for emergency services to do a wellness check, I'm of a firm opinion that these kinds of thoughts, questions, and answers are the sign of a mind that has no problems asking tough questions and digging out the tough answers. It's a periodic quest we should all experience to help keep our focus. Some call it a retreat, annual planning conference, or as with me, it's a morning spent digging as deep as time allows, follow away with the results, and revisit during vacation. So, what does your compass say? What have you mapped in your life and turned over to the automatic GPS system, and is it taking you where you plan, or is it a little off course? Have you updated the maps of life that you're living by? Are they still current? Is that internal gyroscope tweaked for top performance? So, I plan for the future. I analyze my recent past and the direction of my life, and I plan for the future. But planning without action is ludicrous. It's probably a sign of some form of the laziness disease. You can do part, but not all, because all requires discipline to change, and discipline requires effort until it becomes part of your daily routine. You know, that part of your life that just functions without thought. At the same time, acting without a plan is a similar disease. It's called irrational behavior. It gets you into trouble and desperately far from normality. It was Benjamin Franklin who said, by failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail. So, I read, study, think, and ask important questions. The answers are on a worksheet that allows me to revisit them time and again and make sure I'm headed in the right direction. Here's my thought today. I believe, as a created being, that there is a purpose for each of us. We have been given a great gift to accomplish great things, but this present life presents obstacles that we must control or either be beat down by them. God spoke to Israel with a phrase I've used often in my planning cycle of life. In Jeremiah 29:11, he speaks, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, thoughts of peace, not of evil, to give you a future and a hope." Here's my thought again. God knows. There is a future. There is hope. There is peace. I just need to keep my focus on that direction.